Hello, Cancer. I need to clear my throat there. Welcome to your 2019 energy forecast. I clearly need to drink water right now. I've been talking all day. Please excuse me. Congratulations on being the number two highest views for last month. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a swift little energy overview for you for the year 2019. Welcome if you're new. Hello again if you are a ride or die subscriber. Thanks for your support. But anywho, oh yeah, and everything you guys need to know is in a description box below this video. But what we're going to do is we're going to look at, because I have only the major arcana here, because these are all spiritual lessons. So we're going to look at an overall energy for 2019, and then we're going to look at things that are going to come into your awareness, subconscious influences, and catalytic challenges, and what's not, or whatever. So we're going to ask Spirit to give us clear and direct guidance for my Cancerians for the year of 2019. Anything that is for their highest good, anything that will assist them with challenges and obstacles that they may face this year. Spirit, I ask that that be revealed in this reading. Anything that can contribute to the highest good of my Cancerians, as well as assisting them in their growth, as well as overall evolution. And I thank you in advance. I got some sage burning over here. I got my little Himalayan salt candle going, so... And I got my little humidifier thingy over there. So, if I seem like super breezy, it's because of the good vibes I got going over here. And lastly, I'm going to pull a card from a deck of universal truths that I have that will be your first meditative mantra for 2019. The year of abundance. Okie dokie, lemon chokey. Let's see what we got going on here. Okay. Sorry, I'm giggling, but it's good. Anyway, so your overall energy for the year is the Hermit card. Seek and you shall find. I see this very similar to how it is, I'm saying the energy is very similar to, well, not very, but slightly similar to what it is that I picked up for Gemini. It's again, surrendering to the all. I should have known that reading energy was going to get very existential, but it's like surrendering to the all, descending into your lower self to find your innate truth about yourself, about life. Knowing that you have the power and authority to define those things for yourself and to move forward in alignment with that truth. So I see Cancerians entering 2019 in a very reflective state. It's more or less not wanting to move until the next step becomes very real and true for you, almost as if it's a part of yourself, if that makes sense. It's like, I don't know, I get the sense, but then I instantly thought of like all of Cancer's readings from this entire year. It's like you guys like consistency, you guys like knowing home, so to speak. It's like you like knowing that you're safe and protected, as well as, like, I mean, in reference to your environment and the people that are surrounding you. And I feel like a great deal of that has been robbed from Cancer, proverbially speaking, in the last year. So it's almost that there's been so much inconsistency that you guys got to a place where you didn't know up from down, you didn't know left from right. You didn't know friends from foes, because a lot of things that you guys experienced in 2018 was completely out of sorts. Like, I feel like you guys may have even seen sides of people that you would have never fathomed that you saw. You were disappointed in ways that you never thought you'd be disappointed, and foundations that you guys thought were unbreakable broke. So it kind of left you in this place to where you felt like a stranger in your own life, if that makes sense. So having come out of this, and all of you may not be completely out of it, but I feel like the worst is over. So it's like the calamity of it all may be over and the dust is settling. But I feel like you guys are going into 2019 in a very observant state, to where if something isn't 100% for you, you don't want to step forward with it unless you're absolutely sure. But I think that's a good prep for the energy you guys are going to be in, because it's more or less letting you know that sureness in the confidence that you guys are going to have to take those steps forward comes from your alignment with spirit. So in this state where you're in this reflective mode, you're kind of, I would say, kind of shell-shocked, you know what I mean? Because it's, I think you guys are having issues with trust and stuff going into 2019. Like I said, it's like from the different tumultuous things that you guys have experienced up to this point. So the advice for you guys, I suppose you could say, is that confidence that you're seeking, that foundation that you're seeking, is alignment with spirit. Because that will give you the intuitive ability or the discernment required to move forward with confidence, right? So to give you guys kind of like a peek behind the veil, in a sense, this is you guys getting comfortable with aligning with your higher self, which is your card of awareness for this year. So it's more or less, you guys will come to see as the year starts to unfold, when you look back at 2018 in hindsight, you'll start to see that all of the truths that came out, or the people who acted completely out of character, was a blessing in disguise, in a sense, because you were able to see what you were, like, what you had really built, the life you had really built, the people that you had really let in, the byproduct of decisions that were made, the byproduct of partnerships that were made. And it's showing you a contrast to who and what you really are, if that makes sense. So it's like now you guys may feel kind of, I don't want to say unhinged, but it's feeling in this liaison phase. It's almost like I've moved too far to go backwards, but I don't know where I'm going, so I don't feel comfortable enough to step forward. But that's where I say it's similar to Gemini, because it's finding peace in that not knowing and trusting that everything is going to unfold for your highest good, because all of these things crumbling and falling were really spirit's way of chiseling away at the hardness around your heart to almost save you from yourself, in a sense, or to save you from the negative byproduct of the disappointments of 2018. Because the thing that I'm really sensing is here is that what could have happened, or what maybe some of you guys may have thought you were heading towards, was completely shutting off your heart space and closing off your emotions, closing off your feelings, cutting people off and kind of isolating yourself, like in the hermit reverse type of mode. But it's almost like, it's almost like you're in an incubation type of state right now. And spirit isn't going to allow that to happen, because for a lot of you guys, I'm hearing it's a calling type of thing. So it's all, like, I just keep hearing the whole chiseling thing. So this whole process was so that things that are not in alignment with you, things that were not ordained to go with you into this new abundant year that you guys are stepping in, that's all of the things, and it may take you some time to see that. Don't force yourself, because it's going to come in due time. But the more in communion that you become with spirit, the more familiar that you become with your higher state of being, the clearer that this will become and the more sense it'll make in the long run, if that makes sense, right? In your subconscious process, so wonderful, we have the balance card. So in so many ways, guys, this is, and that's temperance, BTW. It's a transmutation that you guys are going through, and the transmutation of, I call it the alchemical ladder, you know? So it's ascending, if you think, might be something you guys might want to research since it's coming up, the 12 rays. It's like ascending up your chakra system to this higher state of being. Because, of course, you may or may not know, we have the seventh chakra, which is the crown chakra, but your auric body goes all the way up to 12. And that's what I talk about with the whole golden aura. That's the 12th ray. But that's more or less like what the whole, you know, metaphor of alchemy is, of turning lead into gold. It's ascending each level of being from your human chakras to the most important chakra, which is the heart, because that's the chakra that marries your human to your higher self, right? And then after that, it's ascending to those higher states of being, and then your etheric body, so to speak. But it's all of this upheaval, this back and forth, this imbalance, all of that is just merely the byproduct of you coming into union with the self. So it's your divine masculine and feminine energy, your yin and yang, and that's the subconscious influence that's more or less, you could say co-creating, because I was thinking about that with Gemini's reading. It's like the whole thing with co-creating is that your higher self and spirit are always working in accordance with each other. But the key is getting the human on task with the higher self and with spirit, right? And that's the hardest thing of all. It's gaining dominion over your experiences, like I said, with Gemini, where you don't feel at the will of it. But it's understanding that in order for things to fall together in the 3D realm, it's not going to look like what it is that's happening in a spiritual sense, right? And of course, your catalyst is the Chariot card. So the catalyst in all of this is to align with these energies, right? To reveal your inner self, to attune with your heart space, to cultivate a relationship with spirit if you don't have one, right? And just like I think I told Gemini that, but it's like studying the laws of the universe. It's studying the laws of karma, just to give you a foundational base to interpret the different experiences that you have in life and even to guide your decisions. Learning the difference between, and I know this sounds super like simple, but learning the difference between higher vibrational energies and lower vibrational energies and understanding where you fit in between the two, right? And with this subconscious process, it's not really so much about attacking that head on, but this is just a key to let you know whenever you confront something in your external life is to more or less allow this to be, what is it that I'm seeing? It's like it was in cereal boxes back in the day, like a decoder. So it's like if there's like a message and you put the little thing on top of it, then you can see the message. So I guess like a decoder or something of the sort, but it's like allowing this card to be that for you. So anytime you face something that makes you feel uncomfortable or you feel that you're coming upon some sort of opposition, it's to remember, okay, if my subconscious process that I'm trying to work out, right, which is, you know, funny that your conscious is trying to understand the subconscious, but it's neither here nor there. It's just understanding that your goal in all of this is to find a happy balance between whatever it is that you're experiencing. So how is it that I can make this a win-win situation for me, but not in alignment with an egoic win? So both with the Chariot and with the Temperance card, a lot of what you guys are going to be cultivating this year is coming out of 2019 and going into 2020 in a state of balance inwardly and outwardly, because the Chariot is the external manifestation of an inner balance, right? So that's what's going to be at the heart of everything that you guys are encountering this year. But the most important thing of all of this is knowing that as you go through this process, the more you're getting to know your authentic self and coming out of alignment with the inauthentic self. But the whole key of having success this year is you attuning with spirit, right? Cultivating a relationship with spirit. And like I said with Gemini, I hope that makes sense. I pray that makes sense. 15 minutes, I'm doing good. All right, so I'm going to pick a card. This is a deck of universal truths and what's not or whatever. So I'm going to pick a card for Cancerians that will act as your mantra going into this year. And you guys can write this down, because I don't know which one is going to come out, but some of them are, like, really existential. So they could end up being, you know, what is that even saying? But I would still write it down anyway and utilize it as a meditative mantra to begin the year with. I hope that made sense, Cancer. Oh, well. That's two. First one. You have nothing to learn about relationships. You have only to demonstrate what you already know. Next, it says, remember you this, that which you condemn will condemn you, and that which you judge will one day become. What? Remember, let me start over. Remember you this, that which you condemn will condemn you, and that which you judge you will one day become. Rather seek to change those things or support others who are changing those things, which no longer reflect your highest sense of who you are.
That's exactly what I was saying. That's why I like these. Yay.
So in so many ways, and this brings me back to the thing I was saying with a lot of you guys stepping into your calling. And this, again, this must be like a collective theme. It's really about you mastering your experience and you being qualified as a teacher for others because of mastering your own experience. So another person that you encounter on the journey that is presently in a place that you were, you can speak to them from a place, not from a book or from some authority outside of yourself, but from your actual real life experience, which honestly, in all truth, is the best teacher, in my opinion. But that has been your forecast, Cancer, for 2019. Keep an eye out for you guys' January generals that are coming out. I hope that this was helpful. Definitely let me know what you think in the comments. I love your face. Deuces.